tomorrow like we think about now. Can we survive it out there? Can we make it somehow? I guess I thought that this would never end, and suddenly it's like the women and men. Will the past be a shadow that will follow us around? Will this memories fade when I leave this town? I keep thinking that it's not goodbye. I keep on thinking it's our time to fly.
Yeah. this moment in the back of my mind. The time we stood with our shaking hands, the crowds and stands went wild. We were the kings and the queens, and they read off our names. The night you danced like you knew our lives would never be the same. You held your head like a hero on a history book page. It was the end of a decade, but the start of an age. Long live this feeling. I passed the pictures around of all the years that we stood there on the sidelines, wishing for right now. We are the kings and the queens. You traded your baseball cap for a crown when they gave us our trophies.
Long live the walls we crashed. have myself a real good time. I feel alive. And the world, I'm turning inside out. Yeah. I'm floating around in ecstasy. So
don't stop me now.
Defying the laws of gravity, I'm a racing car passing by like Lady Godiva. I'm gonna go, go, go. There's no stopping me. I'm burning through the sky, 200 degrees. Just while they call me Mr. Fahrenheit.
Check, check, check.
Something at the speed of light. I wanna make a supersonic man out of you. Don't stop me now.
Check, check, check.
I'm having a ball.
Stop me now.
If you wanna have a good time, just give me a call.
Stop me now.
I'm having a good time.
Stop me now.
I'm having a good time. I don't wanna stop at all. I'm a rocket ship on my way to Mars on a collision course. I'm a satellite, I'm out of control. I'm a sex machine ready to reload like an atom bomb about to
explode.
I'm burning through the sky, yeah. 200 degrees, that's why they call me Mr. Fahrenheit. I'm traveling at the speed of light. I wanna make a supersonic woman of you.
Don't stop me, don't stop me, don't stop me.
Hey, hey, hey!
Don't stop me, don't stop me. Ooh, ooh, ooh.
I like
don't stop
it.
Me, don't stop me.
Have a good time, good time.
Don't stop me, don't stop me.
Oh!
Sonic man out of you. Don't stop me now.
I'm having such a good time. I'm having a ball.
Don't stop me now.
If you wanna have a good time, just give me a call.
Don't stop me now.
I'm having a good time.
Don't stop me
yes,
now.
I'm having a good time. I don't wanna stop at all.
Everybody, welcome. I'm hoping we all have our seats by now. We're going to begin our ceremony. Welcome, parents, family, friends, and supporters. On behalf of Holy Trinity Catholic High School, I welcome you to the 2023 graduation. You have much to be proud of, and your presence here today means a great deal to the fortunate young adults who are here to be acknowledged for their many years of hard work and dedication. My name is Jerome McGregor, and I am the chaplain at Holy Trinity High School, and I will be your MC for today's events. How I got this job was very interesting. The students first asked the smartest teacher to be the MC, but they declined. Then they asked the most attractive teacher to be the MC, but they declined. Then they asked the most liked teacher to be the MC, but again, they declined. Finally, the students asked me to be the MC. And I said, I've already declined three times, But since you're so persistent, I will do it. So that's why you have me today. Today's program, as you notice, there's no paper programs. It's on a QR code. You'll see them scattered around in different places. So if you were born before the year 2000, please ask a young person to do this for you. All right, then you'll be able to follow along and see what's coming. Please note that if you do not laugh at any of my attempted jokes, I will not be offended. Many people do not. But I will leave you my cell phone number with you later. So just in case you get any, you can just text me, ha ha. And speaking of ha ha, and any other acknowledgements, we are fortunate to be here at this venue. This is our first time in history the whole Trinity has been here. I got to admit, I'm just happy that I didn't have to set up any of the chairs or take any of them down. So that's why I'm happy to be here today. We are on a somewhat tight timeline, so because there's another school that will be coming in after us for their grad. So we have to keep on schedule, and then we have to get out. Right? So unless you want to hang around for their grad as well. All right. Therefore, we're asking you to hold your applause until the end of the ceremony. Right? Then we can clap and shout and jump for joy. Right? So thank you for your participation and understanding with this. So applause and all that to the very end. Nice. Okay. Pictures. As you can see, we don't have a lot of room, so we can't have anyone in the aisles. There's lots of movement in the aisles to try to get that perfect photo op. So please take pictures from your seat. If your graduate wins an award, they'll have a picture taken off stage, okay? And then we also have something set up in the foyer for pictures. So I know a lot of you love to take pictures, but we just have to keep you sort of in your seats and not all over the place, okay? You may notice our lovely stage and how lovely it is, and I'd like to give special recognition to Bradford Greenhouses for their donation of these floral bouquets. So we thank them very much. Yes, we can have a clap for that for sure. Also, very much worthy of acknowledgement is the Parent Council, who supplied the beautiful pens that each student will get in their gift bag at the end of the ceremony, as well as the Mongilo family for their stunning religious medallions that are also in the gift bag. So when the students are going to enter, I will ask you to stand, and once they are in place, we will continue to stand for O Canada, then the opening prayer, which will be delivered by our special guest, Father John Pack, the pastor at our very own Holy Martyrs of Japan parish. If you have the program open, you'll notice that there's names of honored guests that will be delivering messages to our graduates, and I will introduce them as they appear. And here today, but not delivering a message, is our trustee Tanya Da Silva. So, on behalf of our principal, Mr. Heinrich Bebier, the school staff, the teachers, and of course the graduating students of 2023, would you please stand? Going to ask you now, please, graduates, to stand for O Canada. Everybody, please remain standing as I call Father John Pack to come and lead us in their opening prayer.
Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen, honored guests, faculty, staff, and most importantly, the graduate clean class of Holy Trinity Catholic High School of 2023. As we come together to commemorate and bless the significant milestone of our graduates' lives, it is fitting that we celebrate this special moment with prayer in our Catholic Christian faith. Let us begin our prayer in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Let us pray. Heavenly Father, bless each graduate gathered here today. Surround them with your love and protection as they embark on new adventures and pursue their dreams. May they use their talents, gifts, and education to make a positive impact in the world, guided by the principles of compassion, justice, and respect for all. We ask this through Christ our Lord. Amen. Now let us pray together the prayer that Jesus taught us himself. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us, and lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Amen. Now we will give our graduates a special blessings. Graduates, please bow your heads and receive God's blessing. Blessed are you, God of all ages, for you have been our refuge and dwelling place throughout generations. On this day of celebration, we rejoice in the marvelous work you have begun in our graduates. We trust in your faithfulness to bring it to completion in the days and years ahead. Therefore, we humbly seek your abundant blessings upon them. May the God of all creation, who has numbered our days before they came to be, bestow his favor upon each and every one of you, leading you from strength to strength. May the God of all wisdom, who sent holy prophets to guide and instruct us, ignite a flame of integrity within you. May he empower you to speak the truth with love, pursue justice, and act with wisdom in all your endeavors. May the God of infinite compassion, whose love is perfected when we love one another, steer your hearts to seek the common good. May he grant you the capacity to forgive both friends and enemies, and inspire you to live a life of generosity and compassion towards all. May the God of all salvation, whose mercy abounds and anger is slow to rise, keep you far from harm and shield you from evil. When troubles arise, may he be your refuge, restoring you to wholeness and granting you peace. May the God of all understanding bring purpose and meaning to your endeavors. May he illuminate your path, infuse joy into your encounters with others, and grant you the wisdom to discern what is right and the courage to follow his will for your life. May the peace of God surpassing all understanding guard your hearts and minds, soothing your fears and relieving your doubts. May he sustain you with unwavering hope, even in the face of adversity. May the road rise up to meet you. May the wind be always at your back. May the sun shine warm upon your face. The rains fall soft on your fields. And until we meet again, may God hold you in the palm of his hand. And may the blessing of God, the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit be upon each of you and remain with you forever and ever. Amen. On behalf of Father Joseph, Deacon David, Mr. Reitzel, our youth minister, all the staff and parishioners of Holy Martyrs Japan Parish, I wish your best wishes and congratulations.
Thank you, Father. You may now have a seat. In order to make maybe any nervous grads feel comfortable today, I will be saying my usual dad jokes that I normally start the day off with. This is for you guys. Now, this graduation class was very much affected by the COVID disruption, so they are used to doing courses online. So therefore, what do you call doctors who graduated online? Google Docs. There's plenty more of those, right? There's plenty more of those. I'd like to now call upon, we're going to have messages, and I'd like to call upon our Director of Education, Ms. Frances Begley, to come up and address our graduating class.
Thank you so very much. I am delighted to be here this afternoon as you graduate from Holy Trinity Catholic High School. It's an honor to join you along with your family, your friends, and the staff to celebrate this important milestone in your educational career. As you reflect on your journey to get to this point, I truly hope that you are filled with pride and a joyful sense of anticipation about what will come next. You have grown not only academically, but spiritually, embracing the values that lie at the heart of Catholic education. As we celebrate the Sacred Heart of Jesus during this month of June, I want you to focus on receiving and returning Jesus' love with gratitude, giving back to the world with all your heart, your soul, and your strength. This is our devotion to the Sacred Heart of Jesus. True giving is always costly, but it always gives goodness and life to someone else in return, just as Jesus gave his life for us. Sometimes our world may seem clouded by uncertainty and worry. We strive to ensure that our schools are places where faith, love, and service are always nurtured, where the light of faith shines the way for staff and students alike. It is with this confidence and belief that we bid our graduates goodbye and good luck. We trust in your ability to shine as beacons of faith, illuminating the world with your God-given talents and unwavering love for others. Within the walls of your school, you have constantly been encouraged to discover your unique gifts and talents. Maybe you're a budding artist, or a talented musician, or a skilled athlete, or an aspiring scientist. Maybe you have a way with words, or maybe you are a whiz with numbers. Maybe your bright light dazzles for all of those around you, or maybe your light is a constant and steady glow. No matter what the next few years hold in store for you, I want you each to be brave enough to let your light shine. Be that beacon of faith, and in doing so, encourage others to do the same. Building communities that are united by their acceptance of many different talents and skills. Maybe the things that inspire and lift you up will also inspire and uplift others that you meet. Remember that it is your character that truly will define you. You have learned the importance of kindness, empathy, and compassion. You know how important it is to reach out to the marginalized, to comfort the grieving, and to offer a helping hand to all of those in need. As you step into the world, the light that is your faith will show you the way and constantly illuminate your path. Continue to lead with this hope and compassion, and always let your God-given talents inspire others. Foster unity wherever you go, and commit to making a difference. Build bridges along the way and with those you connect with. Class of 2023, as you embark on this new chapter of your life, always remember the lessons that you have learned at Holy Trinity. Carry with you those values that have shaped you into the remarkable individuals that we are celebrating here this afternoon. May your next steps be filled with endless opportunities for growth, for joy, and for fulfillment. Always trust in who you are and the abilities that you bring to any activity that you participate in. And be courageous, knowing that your faith will guide you through all of the challenges that may come your way. And always remember that by illuminating the lives of others, you will find your own purpose. Congratulations, graduates of 2023. We believe in you, and we are confident that you will continue to illuminate the world with all of the talents and unwavering love that you have shown to others throughout your years at Holy Trinity and beyond. God bless you all abundantly, and may He keep you safe. Thank you.
Wonderful. Thank you very much, Ms. Bagley. And of all nine high schools to have come to, she chose ours. So we're very honored that you came here today. I'd like to now call upon the Catholic School Community Chair, Ms. Joanne Gallo.
Good afternoon, Director Bagley, Mr. Bebier, dignitaries, parents, and our graduating class of 2023. As the Chair of Holy Trinity's Parent Council, I'm honored to be here as we celebrate this big milestone in your lives, graduation. This day is all about you. We are all in amazement at the inspiring and resilient people that you've become. Now is the time for you to dream big, because anything is possible, and this world is yours to discover. As parents, we feel a tremendous responsibility to instill and support the Catholic way of life for each and every one of you. This is why the Parent Council works with the staff to lean in and bring our school community together. As Chair of Parent Council for the past 6 years, I have seen us take great strides forward and make a positive impact. This is what is so special about what we do. We bring together a community, the church, the school, and all of you, together with your families, to make Holy Trinity an amazing place to be. I'd like to take this opportunity to thank Mr. Bebier for always being there to guide and support us so that we could fulfill our goals. Without you, this would not have been possible. We will miss you very much. But this is definitely not goodbye. Rather, it's a see you later. Graduates, look ahead and dream of all the bright possibilities your future holds. Today and for the rest of your lives, may all of your dreams come true. We pray that this is the beginning of a successful new chapter. We want nothing but the best for you. I pray that you will stay grounded in your faith, and remember that you have a supportive community around you as you embark on this next phase of your journey. Always remember that there are no mistakes, only life lessons. live life to the fullest, laugh a lot, aim for the highest star, and most of all, remember to always let God be an integral part of your life. He will always be your guide if you allow him. May God bless you all. Congratulations, class of 2023.
All right, thank you very much, Ms. Gallo. So I'd now like to call upon our principal, Mr. Heinrich Bebre, a man who can elevate small talk to medium talk. Please welcome Mr. Bebre.
Good afternoon, Holy Trinity. I'm going to miss saying that every day. I look out here today and I see 1,700 beautiful people who are staring at me. And I'm going to do my best not to get emotional, I promise. And I'm sure my wonderful staff have bets going on right now on whether or not I can hold this together, but I'm going to do my best. I think it's truly an honor and a privilege that I stand here today in front of all of you, the class of 2023. I can't thank my dignitaries enough for being here. We have them all here, including our director, our mayor, Father John. We have our counselors here. We have our sponsors here as well, my incredible teachers, and of course, my amazing administrators, Mr. Borgia, Mr. Morrison, even, of course, Mr. DeFilippo is here, and Ms. McNamara. She passes on our congratulations to all of you as well. So again, thank you. Being here to celebrate with you today is honestly one of the high points of my life. Their ceremony is designed to mark the end of one phase of your life and the beginning of the next. As Ms. Gallo had indicated, if it wasn't for our strong community and our Catholic roots and, you know, our relationship to our parish, I honestly don't think any of us would be here today. But it's with their guidance and support and the love and caring of all your families that we are here to mark the end of our journey in high school. All of you will be, of course, forever etched in the memory for years to come. Not just in the yearbook, Gracie Viveros, thank you very much for doing that. And one thing that I'm very proud of is our motto at our school, to grow through love and example. This is a motto that all of you live by each and every day, and it is something that I want you to remember. It is what Jesus wants us to do. If I have any advice for you, it is this. You are here on this earth to love God and others. This is the great purpose of life. Peace, love, and friendship. These gifts cost us nothing, but honestly, they really make a big difference. I love stories, and I've been going to Bradford, and I was a principal up in Barrie at St. Pete's for 6 years, but I've been traveling the same route each and every day for the past 20 years. So, quick story for you. I go through the Tim Hortons in Bradford, the little drive-through, and every Friday, we have a little tradition that goes on, and it's about paying it forward. Someone in front of me will usually buy me a coffee, and then I buy the person's order behind me, so on and so forth. Does that make my day? It does. Is it meaningful? It certainly does. And I think it's really important that all of you find that ritual in your life where you can slow down. All of you are on your way to college, university, apprenticeship, or workplace. It's not the degree or diploma that's on your wall that's going to change your life or make a difference. It will be the random acts of kindness, such as a small cup of coffee, that will make the difference in someone's day. My ritual has always been, I go grab my coffee, I come back, and I'll sit in the morning. I'm an early riser because of my dog, Charlie. All of you know my dog. And I will go into the chapel every morning and thank God that I'm here, and I'm very blessed. Purpose is something else that was mentioned in one of our speeches. It is essential. You need to find a purpose, and all of you have a purpose. You just will find it later on in life. Your parents are the DNA that you are going to carry forward, and I think that's pretty incredible that your parents who are here tonight to celebrate your success, you are part of them, and that's why they are here tonight, and they're very, very proud of all of you. Your very existence is wrapped up in the things you are here to fulfill, though. Whatever you choose for a career path, remember, there's going to be some struggles and obstacles along the way. That's very normal. But when I see God in people who are there to support you each and every day. And that's then those acts that will support you. I think it's really important as well, graduates, you need to be a change maker. A change maker requires more than just speaking out. It requires listening. Listening is really important. Another quick story for you. I had a paper route from grade 4 to grade 12, and it was in a seniors building, 82 customers. I used to collect $1.10 a week for the St. Catherine Standard, and I would come home and say to my mom, "Mom, these people, all they want to do is talk and talk and talk." And it would take me an entire weekend to collect money from 82 people. But I realized at that point in time, I wasn't just the paper boy. I was the person who went out to the grocery store, bought them groceries. I was the one who bought them cigarettes through my mom, go to the drugstore, and that connection I developed, and you know, back then, it was the stories that they wanted to hear. I think that's really important too, because it made me realize that there's a lot of lonely people in our world, and we can make a difference by slowing down and acknowledging them. So please keep that in mind. We can make the best of it, or you can make the worst of it. I hope you make the best of it. I hope you see things that stare at you. I hope you feel things that you've never felt before. I hope you meet people that have different points of view. And believe me, you're going to meet a lot of people with different points of view. I hope you live a life you are proud of, and I hope you continue to smile and laugh a lot. This graduating class of 2023, one thing that made our day and my amazing administrators and the teachers, we always had a laugh with you every day. And parents, you know, people would say, "Well, you have a tough job." I have the best job. I really do. Because I get to go to the art shows and to the sports banquets. I get to walk into a classroom with my administrators and celebrate the successes of our incredible students. With that comes the price, because with that rapport, they also have had a lot of laughs through me. Quick example. We have the prank day every year. Prank day stresses me out, but I always know at the end of it, no one's gonna get hurt and we're gonna have a good laugh. So this year's prank day, I was exhausted by the end of it. We had balloons, of course, in the school. Kids had a water balloon fight outdoors. And then someone wrapped my leased Jeep, thank you, Mr. Cayetta, in cellophane. So I walked outside and it was all wrapped up and all I could do was laugh. But I thought to myself, maybe it's the vehicle I'm driving, because there was a prank many years back when I drove a Jeep and a number of students had my phone number because I had the privilege of traveling to Ecuador with them. And one day my phone started to ring and it just kept ringing and ringing and ringing. It wouldn't stop. So I discovered when I answered the phone, "Hello?" And the person said, "Yes, I'm calling about the Jeep that you have listed on Kijiji. And I'm sorry for your hard time. I'm willing to come there right now and pay you cash." So I'm like, "What is this?" The grade 12s had posted my Jeep with my phone number and said, "Going through a really bad divorce. Need cash ASAP." So it was pretty funny. Thank you. So make sure you laugh a lot. And I've already talked about the idea of, you know, never underestimate the power of a smile, a kind word. One of the things I really enjoyed every day was doing my parking lot duty, where I could go out back and wish you all a good morning. And please, please, please never forget that. So it is with mixed feelings that we say goodbye. In the passage through life, walk hand in hand with God as your destination. Look over your shoulder with fond memories of Holy Trinity to your warm heart. Forge ahead with hopes and dreams. To my amazing teachers, I can't thank you enough. You've made me and my administrators look like rock stars. We often take the credit and we don't deserve the credit. You're the ones who've devoted all that extra time doing extracurricular, soccer, Mamma Mia, whatever it might be, arts, and we show up and get the glory. You are the ones that deserve the credit. You have opened up the world of learning to our grads, so continue to pursue excellence. To our parent, to all of your parents, again, I've had such a strong connection with all of you. I love you all very much. Thank you for the coffee, the cannolis, the gift cards. Thank you for taking care of me and my staff. We honor, and to our grads, make sure you honor and love them each and every day. They have done you and supported you forever. So, I end with a quote. Yesterday is history, tomorrow is a mystery, today is a gift. That is why we call it the present. Love you all.
Thank you, Mr. Bebe. You know we're going to miss you very much. And if it continues to make your day, you may come by on Fridays and buy me a coffee. I'll do that for you. All right, I'd like to now call upon Mr. James LeDuc, the mayor of the town of Bradford West Gwillimbury.
Mr. Bebe, tough act to follow. Good afternoon, educators, parents, family members, and of course, grads. For those who don't know me, my name is James LeDuc. I'm the mayor of Bradford West Gwillimbury. I'm honored to be here today to celebrate this milestone event with you all. I must admit, it took me quite some time to think of how I wanted to address you all today. What words of wisdom, motivation, inspiration could I possibly deliver to a much younger generation than I, which will resonate with you? What can I share that will guide you as you take this significant leap towards your future? After going back and forth, contemplating whether using references to popular TikTok videos, which would help you better connect with me, or choosing to share insight into lessons I've seen my own children experience early in their adult life, the answer became very clear. Choices. Making right choices. Making wrong choices. Learning from those choices. Choosing friends. Choosing classes to enroll in. Choosing whether you give into peer pressure. Choosing whether to pursue post-secondary education, taking time off, or get straight to work. You get the point. Life is all about choices. So what do I want to leave you with today as you celebrate this momentous event in your lives? Although I thought of making choices every day may feel overwhelming, stressful, or like it's just too much, remember this about choices. Choices test us, and those are the hardest to make because tough choices are often up against easier alternative. Just remember that an easy path is not always the right path. Choices teach us. You may not always make a good choice or the right choice, and that is okay too, because it provides us with the opportunity to learn and grow and make more conscientious and thoughtful choices in the future. Choices mold us. Every choice you make, today, tomorrow, the next year, grows into a collection of choices that set the path for your future. One day you will look back on the choices you've made and realize that each and every choice, right or wrong, has made you who you are. Thank you for the wonderful educational staff here at Holy Trinity and for your commitment to these young adults over the past 4 years and for instilling the skills of perseverance, hard work, and compassion into our future leaders. On behalf of the town of Bradford, West Glenbury, community members, myself, and fellow council members, congratulations on your tremendous achievement. We're incredibly proud of all of you for reaching this milestone in your educational journey. Congratulations, 2023 graduating class of Holy Trinity, and remember, above all else, choose kindness, acceptance, compassion, and empathy. And no matter where life takes you over the next few years, I hope you choose to build your life in Bradford, West Glenbury. Thank you.
Thank you very much. Beautiful words. I also wanted to say one last thing. Ms. Gennaro, our amazing office administrator, has been with us for 38 years. She's been with us since 1985, when Holy Trinity was first founded, and we were located above the bank in town. Ms. Gennaro, whereabouts are you? Would you mind standing up? Thank you. We can't thank you enough for everything that you've done over the 38 years. Thank you for everything, and we look forward to perhaps traveling together one day. Finally, one last person. When we speak of retirement, we've had a lot of administrators who've come back to help us. Mr. Cam Morrison, if he can stand up for as well. Thank you. And Mr. Morrison has been been a principal for a number of years. He has come to help us out as well. So Mr. DeFilippo and I really think. Thank you very much.
All right, always got to have the last word, eh, Mr. Bebe? All right, so we are going to move along now, everybody, giving out the diplomas. But I did want to mention that when I saw Father John here today, it reminded me of a dad joke. What do you call a priest that has graduated from law school? Father-in-law. All right, so now we're going to get into our diplomas section. So we're going to be calling up, and then essentially what's going to happen, people, do you know that students will be coming up, processing onto the stage and receiving their diploma, and if they've won an award, they will get it, and they will get a picture on the side.
Good afternoon, everyone. It is my honor and privilege to announce our graduates as they receive their diplomas. So I'd ask if the graduates begin to line up. It's Christine that goes first. Christine, you ready? Our first graduate is Christine Gargolis. Next is Martin Mangeres. Gabriel Parsons. And Mishko Kasjak. Mishko is an Ontario scholar. He also receives the Bradford Knights of Columbus Faith, Hope, and Charity Award. This is awarded to the graduating student who has demonstrated growth in their faith and attends Mass regularly. Okay, one up. Rami Adnan España. Rami is the recipient of the Technology, Drama, Music and Art Red Seal Diploma. Daniel Adodo. Louis Aguirre. Aiden Aladi, Ontario Scholar. Aiden also receives the Diana Riffert Law Award. This award is presented to the student who has achieved academic excellence in the course. Aiden also receives the school letter, awarded to the student who has contributed to academics, athletics, co-curricular, and our Catholic community. Jalen Alfaro. Jury Alcassi, Ontario Scholar. Jury receives two awards from the Bradford Lions presented by Mrs. Sellers. She receives the Bradford Lions George Jackson History Award and the University English Award, both for achieving academic excellence in the course. She also receives the Royal Canadian Legion Branch 521 Psychology Award presented by Mrs. Brooks. This award is presented to the student who has achieved academic excellence. She also receives the Dr. Leanne Ng Scholarship. It is awarded to a graduating female student entering post-secondary education, has made notable contributions to the school and community, and achieved academic excellence. Natasha Alvarez. Sophia Alves. Ariana Amadeus. Ariana is the recipient of the Technology, Drama, Music, and Art Red Seal Diploma. Chris Ampadu. Chris is the recipient of the Health and Wellness Red Seal Diploma. Andres Antonucci, Ontario Scholar. Naren Oshana, Ontario Scholar. Naren is the recipient of the Health and Wellness Red Seal Diploma. Andrew Arajo. Andrew is the recipient of the CWL Holy Martyrs of Japan Open Religion Award. This award is presented to the student who has achieved academic excellence in the course. Sydney Arboleda. Sydney is the recipient of the Technology, Drama, Music, and Art Red Seal Diploma. Tomas Arias. Sean Arias Pesantes. Michaela Armstrong Watson. Aldrin Austria. Aldrin is the recipient of the Health and Wellness Red Seal Diploma. Isabella Azevedo. Isabella has completed 4 years of French studies. Madison Azola. Tommy Baglioni. Andres Barahona. Andres is the recipient of the Health and Wellness Red Seal Diploma. He also receives the Holy Trinity Catholic High School Staff Bursary Award. This is awarded to a graduating student who has demonstrated dedication and consideration for others in the community of Holy Trinity. Angelina Besantes. Angelina is the recipient of the Health and Wellness Red Seal Diploma. J. Mary Bermoy. J. Mary has completed 4 years of French studies. Isabella Berndt. Isabella receives the Martonia Construction Woodworking Technology Award. This award is presented to the student who has achieved academic excellence in the course. Victoria Bird, Ontario Scholar. Victoria also receives the school letter. Jordan Bobala. Raf Bokhtor, Ontario Scholar. Raf is the recipient of the Health and Wellness Red Seal Diploma. He has completed 4 years of French studies. He receives the school letter, the Be Well Chiropractic Health and Wellness Award, as well as the Town of Bradford Valedictorian Award. This is awarded to a student who is elected by his peers to represent the graduating class. Alexander Bolarino. Alexander receives the OECTA Education Award. This is awarded to a graduating student who is entering the field of education. Isabella Bortignon, Ontario Scholar. Isabella has completed 4 years of French studies. Nicholas Botello. Nicholas receives the Bradford Lions Most Improved Student Award presented by Mrs. Sellers. This is awarded to the most academically improved student throughout their high school career. Bradley Bouchard, Ontario Scholar. Bradley receives the Skorchuk Funeral Home College Math Award. This award is presented to the student who has achieved academic excellence in the course. Frank Anthony Cayetta. Frank Anthony receives the school letter. It is awarded to a student who has contributed to academics, athletics, co-curricular, and our Catholic community. Francesco Calabrese. Bianca Collado, Ontario Scholar. Bianca has completed 4 years of French studies. Lucas Camacho. Camila Camacho Montejo, Ontario Scholar. Camila is the recipient of the Health and Wellness Red Seal Diploma. She has completed 4 years of French studies. Camila has successful on the A2 DELF exam and will receive a diploma from France from the Ministry of Education. She also receives the Holy Trinity Prom Committee Leadership Award, awarded to the prom committee member who shows leadership, initiative, and camaraderie to their peers throughout prom planning. Claudia Capicotto, Ontario Scholar. Claudia is the recipient of the Technology, Drama, Music and Art Red Seal Diploma. Mateus Carrero. Juan Carvajal Ramirez, Ontario Scholar. Juan has completed 4 years of French studies. Matthew Carvel Harrow. Anthony Carvalho. Ali Cassiato. Megan Castillo, Ontario Scholar. Megan receives the school letter. It is awarded to the student who has contributed to academics, athletics, co-curricular, and our Catholic community. Evan Chase. Nicholas Chavez. Nicholas receives the Bradford Lions Healthy Active Living Award presented by Mrs. Sellers. This award is presented to the student who has achieved academic excellence in the course. Lavanya Chopra, Ontario Scholar. Caleb Christofferson, Ontario Scholar. Edward Chung. Christian Kochia Glawaki. Bia Cortez, Ontario Scholar. Oh, sorry, Tiago Coelho, Ontario Scholar. Bia Cortez, Ontario Scholar. Bia is the recipient of the Technology, Drama, Music and Art Red Seal Diploma. Matteo Costantino. Lucas Cotterello. Dominique Crognali, Ontario Scholar. Raquel Da Costa, Ontario Scholar. Raquel is the recipient of the Health and Wellness Red Seal Diploma.
Oh my gosh.
Christian Dantis. Leandro DeJesus. Leandro is the recipient of the Technology, Drama, Music and Art Red Seal Diploma. He also receives the Bradford Jewelry by Peter Dyke Spirit Award presented by Counselor Dyke. This is awarded to a graduating student who may work behind the scenes but exemplifies and promotes school and community spirit. He also receives the school letter. Awarded to a student who has contributed to academics, athletics, co-curricular, and our Catholic community. Lucas DeSa. Alexia De Lima, Ontario Scholar. Alexia receives the Summerlin Dental Exceptionalities Award. This is awarded to a student with a learning disability who has shown an exemplary ability to succeed in the face of adversity. Chad Delmas. John Paul DeFede. Jada DiToto, Ontario Scholar. Jada is the recipient of the Health and Wellness Red Seal Diploma. Philippa Diaz, Ontario Scholar. Philippa has completed 4 years of French studies. She receives the Royal Canadian Legion Branch 521 French Award presented by Mrs. Brooks. This award is presented to the student who has achieved academic excellence in the course. She also receives the Dr. Dewey Dentistry University Biology Award, also to the student who has achieved academic excellence in the course, along with the school letter. Natasha Diaz, Ontario Scholar. Damian Drodge. Aiden Dykey. John Ella. Florian Almazi. Chris Ethnasios, Ontario Scholar. Chris is the recipient of the Technology, Drama, Music and Art Red Seal Diploma. Sammy Farah, Ontario Scholar. Sammy has completed 4 years of French studies. Gabriel Ferreira. Gabriel Boavista Ferreira, Ontario Scholar. Gabriel is the recipient of the Health and Wellness Red Seal Diploma. Gabriella Ferreira, Ontario Scholar. Gabriella has completed 4 years of French studies. She was successful on the A2 DELF exam and will receive a diploma from France from the Ministry of Education. Victoria Fick. Victoria is the recipient of the Health and Wellness Red Seal Diploma. She also receives the Roots for Youth Bursary. It is created by the Ferragini family, founding owners of Bradford Greenhouses. The foundation directs charitable efforts to helping teens who have overcome obstacles to pursue a post-secondary education.
Am I getting feedback? Yeah.
Miguel Philippe. Victoria Fior. Scott Fisher, Ontario Scholar. Julian Flamenco. Julian is the recipient of the Health and Wellness Red Seal Diploma. Olivia Freites. Shalini Francis, Ontario Scholar. Shalini receives the Holy Martyrs of Japan Christian Witness Award. This is awarded to a student selected by the Holy Martyrs pastor. This student has participated in church activities, practiced their faith in the community, maintained high religion course marks throughout high school, and is in regular church attendance at Holy Martyrs of Japan Church. McKenna Gagliardi. Corinne Gargolis. Ava Glover. Ava is an Ontario scholar. She receives the following awards: the Piano Music Studio Award for Music and the Edge Imaging Human Growth and Development Award. Both of these awards are for the student who has achieved academic excellence in the course. Aaliyah Gomes. Sabrina Gomes. Gerald Guanlao. Gerald is the recipient of the Technology, Drama, Music and Art Red Seal Diploma. He also receives the Bradford Jewelry by Peter Dyke Best Attendance Award, presented by Counselor Dyke. Natasha Harmaz. Natasha is the recipient of the Health and Wellness Red Seal Diploma. Sherry Hinane. Diego Herrera Figueroa. Emma Hilliard. Emma is the recipient of the Health and Wellness Red Seal Diploma. Selena Imbesi. Hello? Okay, here we go. Sorry. Sophia Imbronio. Sohan Jerome, Ontario Scholar. Maria Gerges. Deborah Junkera. Nathaniel Kalpi, Ontario Scholar. Nathaniel is the recipient of the Health and Wellness Red Seal Diploma. He also receives the Danube Seniors Leisure Center Healthcare Award. This is awarded to the graduating student who is pursuing a career in healthcare. And he receives the Danube Senior Leisure Center Introductory Kinesiology Award, which is awarded to the student who has achieved academic excellence in the course. Nicholas Castoris. Stefan Koziel. Paulina Krikstaponis, Ontario Scholar. Sebastian Kulisha, Ontario Scholar. Anthony Labau. Anthony is the recipient of the Health and Wellness Red Seal Diploma. Mariset Lamasares Ariachi. Marissa Lowry, Ontario Scholar. Marissa has completed 4 years of French studies. Aiden Lieb. Stefano Liuzzi, Ontario Scholar. Stefano is the recipient of the Technology, Drama, Music, and Art Red Seal Diploma. Olivia Lukachuk, Ontario Scholar. Elena Macias Izaretta. Dimitri Mahuta. Lavina Mangiafico. Veronica Marchioni. Marissa Marcos. Ethan Marks, Ontario Scholar. Tristan Marks. Tristan receives the Dungeon Performance Large Group Activities Award. This award is presented to the student who has achieved academic excellence in the course. Cheyenne Marshall. Melanie Martinez, Ontario. Melanie is the recipient of the Health and Wellness Red Seal Diploma. Caitlin Matcham, Ontario Scholar. Caitlin is the recipient of the Technology, Drama, Music and Art Red Seal Diploma. She also receives the Bradford Jewelry by Peter Dyke Spirit Award and the Bradford Jewelry by Peter Dyke Arts Award presented by Councillor Dyke. Liam McCauley, Ontario Scholar. Matthew McDonald. Aniston Mello Pereira, Ontario Scholar. Luca Morante. Inez Mestre. Inez is the recipient of the Health and Wellness Red Seal Diploma. She also completed the 4 years of French studies. She was successful on the A2 DELF exam and will receive a diploma from France from the Ministry of Education. Cecilia Miliero. Cecilia has completed 4 years of French studies. Catherine Miller, Ontario Scholar. Catherine has completed 4 years of French studies. She was successful on the A2 DELF exam and will receive a diploma from France from the Ministry of Education. She also receives the CWL Holy Martyrs of Japan University College Religion Award. This award is presented to the student who has achieved academic excellence in the course. Ashley Miranda. Ashley receives the Trinity Cup Soccer Award. This is awarded to the female graduating student who has played at least 3 years of soccer and has achieved academic excellence in their graduating year. Sophia Moore, Ontario Scholar. Sophia has completed 4 years of French studies. Michaela Molnar. Marissa Mongilo, Ontario Scholar. Marissa receives the Bradford Lions Fitness and Weight Training Award presented by Mrs. Sellers. This award is presented to the student who has achieved academic excellence in the course. Amber Moore. Amber is the recipient of the Health and Wellness Red Seal Diploma. Antonio Mora. Ontario Scholar. Asmita Narmalin, Ontario Scholar. Spencer Natali. Abby Neal. Ashton Nito, Ontario Scholar. Natalie Ng, Ontario Scholar. Alan Nguyen, Ontario Scholar. Felicia Ogbewe. Felicia is the recipient of the Technology, Drama, Music and Art Red Seal Diploma. She also receives the Bradford Jewelry by Peter Dyke Best Attendance Award, presented by Councillor Dyke. Leviu Olarescu. Alejandro Oliva. Woo! Veronica Onyshenko. Lawrence Emil Morola. Lawrence is the recipient of the Health and Wellness Red Seal Diploma. Amono Otto. Amono is an Ontario scholar and is the recipient of the Health and Wellness Red Seal Diploma. Luca Palazzo. Connor Pasquale. Sebastian Pasquale, Ontario Scholar. Sebastian is the recipient of the Health and Wellness Red Seal Diploma. He also receives the school letter. Jonah Pasquantonio, Ontario Scholar. Jonah is the recipient of the Technology, Drama, Music, and Art Red Seal Diploma. Brianna Pinto. Brianna completed 4 years of French studies. Angel Piri Sanchez, Ontario Scholar. Angel receives the Vince Plastic College English Award, as well as the Bradford Lions College Prep Award, presented by Mrs. Sellers. This is the awarded to the graduating student with the highest overall standing in 6 senior college courses, including math and English. Mateo Patoco. Logan Rancourt. Jack Reed, Ontario Scholar. Caden Reinhardt. Alessio Rizzuto. Alessio is the recipient of the Health and Wellness Red Seal Diploma. He receives the Bradford West Gwillimbury Volunteer Firefighters Association Award. This is awarded to the student pursuing a career in the fire service program. This student exhibits a high level of social responsibility, volunteer assisting at school and in the community, dedication, respect, and a good work ethic. Alessio also receives the Trinity Cup Soccer Award. This is awarded to the male graduating student who has played at least 3 years of soccer and has achieved academic excellence in their graduating year. Enzo Roja. Abigail Roman, Ontario Scholar. Abigail is the recipient of the Technology, Drama, Music and Art Red Seal Diploma. She receives the Simcoe Muskoka Catholic District School Board Dual Credit Graduation Award, the CEFO Catholic Student Award, which is awarded to the student whose exemplary conduct, service, and achievement merit the commendation of the Catholic Education Community of Ontario. She also receives the Holy Martyrs of Japan Christian Witness Award and the Sabari Orthodontics Character Recognition Award. This is awarded to the student who consistently models the Catholic values as promoted by the Simcoe Muskoka Catholic District School Board in their everyday student life, and by modeling these values has made a positive impact on their peers' experience within their school community. Jonathan Rosa, Ontario Scholar. Jonathan is the recipient of the Technology, Drama, Music and Art Red Seal Diploma. He has completed 4 years of French studies. Kyle Rosario, Ontario Scholar. Kyle receives the VINS Plastics Advanced Functions Award. This award is presented to the student who has achieved academic excellence in the course. He also receives the school letter. Raquel Russo. Alexa Sakala. Mia Salvador, Ontario Scholar. Gustavo Sandoval Cabrera. Adriana Santos. Keshifa Sakib. Alexander Sargassen. Apisha Sathish Kumar, Ontario Scholar. Apisha is the recipient of the Technology, Drama, Music and Art Red Seal Diploma. Noah Sellers, Ontario Scholar. Noah receives the Mr. Derry Hospitality Technology Award. This award is presented to the student who has achieved academic excellence in the course. Gabriella Sheard, Ontario Scholar. Andrea Silva, Ontario Scholar. Andrea is the recipient of the Technology, Drama, Music and Art Red Seal Diploma. She completed 4 years of French studies. She was successful on the A2 DELF exam and will receive a diploma from France from the Ministry of Education. She also receives the Bradford Orthodontics Outstanding Student Award for College, the Von Chrysler Business Leadership Award, the Rialys No Frills Co-op Award, the Martonia Construction Communications Technology Award, and the Linda's Floral Design Fine Arts Award. All of these awards are presented to the student who has achieved academic excellence in the course. Sarah Silva. Liliana Simoes. Dalida Slewa. Dalida receives the school letter, awarded to the student who has contributed to academics, athletics, co-curricular, and our Catholic community. Avodia Solomon. Julian Sousa Sanchez. Ashley Stapleton. Matthew Svierak.
watch it. Can you say that?
Yep.
You just say it.
Vanessa Tavolacci, Ontario Scholar. Garo Toma. Pintusen Visionthin. Pintusen is the recipient of the Technology, Drama, Music and Art Red Seal Diploma. Angelo Villanueva. Angelo is the recipient of the Health and Wellness Red Seal Diploma. Grace Ann Viveros, Ontario Scholar. Grace Ann is the recipient of the Technology, Drama, Music and Art Red Seal Diploma. She receives the school letter, the Holy Trinity Catholic High School Alumni Award. This is awarded to the graduating student who exemplifies school spirit, demonstrates dedication and consideration for others in the community, shows commitment to co-curricular activities by supporting or participating, and has spent a minimum of 3 years at Holy Trinity. She also receives the Salmon Family Volunteer Award. This is awarded to the student whose extensive volunteer commitment benefits a variety of members of our community. Victoria Vorachuk, Ontario Scholar. Victoria has completed 4 years of French studies, and she receives the school letter. Michaela Warman, Ontario Scholar. Michaela receives the Edge Imaging Philosophy Award and the Imperial Order of the Daughters of Empire for the University Preparation Award. This is awarded to the student with the second highest overall standing in 6 grade 12 university courses. Julian Willits. Carson Wilson, Ontario Scholar. Aubrey Wood. Aubrey is the recipient of the Health and Wellness Red Seal Diploma. Alexandra Rye, Ontario Scholar. She is the recipient of the Technology, Drama, Music and Art Award. She also receives the Doug and Pierrette Osborne Scholarship. This is awarded to a graduating student who is entering post-secondary education and demonstrates leadership and academic dedication. Nicole Yacko, Ontario Scholar. Nicole is the recipient of the Health and Wellness Red Seal Diploma. Odisho Yalda. Mia Yuremko. Mia has completed 4 years of French studies. Sophie Young. Sarah Ute. Sarah receives the Edge Imaging College Chemistry Award. This award is presented to the student who has achieved academic excellence in the course. Michael Zelisnak, Ontario Scholar. Michael receives the following awards: Summerlin Dental Data Management Award, the Tompkins Family Calculus and Vectors Award, the Matwood Holmes University Chemistry Award, the C.F. Crozier's and Associates University Physics Award. All of these awards are for the student that has achieved academic excellence in the course. Michael also receives the Holy Trinity Catholic High School Academic Achievement Award. This is awarded to the student with the highest overall standing in six grade 12 university courses. Chanel Zimmer, Ontario Scholar. Seal Diploma. She receives the School Letter, the Holy Trinity Committee, Prom Committee Leadership Award, the Bradford Orthodontics Outstanding Student University Award, the Bradford Canadian Tire Team Leadership Award, which is awarded to the student who has exemplified community involvement, team spirit, and the importance of inclusion. She also receives the Grow with Gwillimdale Farms Scholarship. This is awarded to a resident of Simcoe County who will be attending college or university in the fall. This student is actively involved in extracurricular activities and volunteer work. This student does and will continue to make a difference in their community in Bradford. And she also receives the QP Custodial Bursary, nominated by Holy Trinity Catholic High School staff members to a graduating student who is a peer leader, willing to help others, and respects all diversity without prejudice. We have two final special graduates of Holy Trinity. As many of you are aware, our longtime principal, Mr. Heinrich Bebier, and the only head secretary Holy Trinity has ever known, are retiring this year. Together, they have attended 68 graduation ceremonies. On behalf of the staff, students, and families of Holy Trinity, please join me in a round of applause as we present Mr. Bebier and Mrs. Gennaro their own, very own special Holy Trinity graduation diplomas. Congratulations to all of our graduates, and at this time, we would like to acknowledge a few more students who will be honored with some very special awards. At this time, I'd like to call to the stage Mrs. Manon Rodriguez. We are pleased to offer the Joseph A. Rodriguez Memorial Award for the Trades on behalf of Joe Rodriguez's family to a deserving graduate whose post-secondary pathway will be in the field of trades. Joe was one of the first students to register at Holy Trinity when the principal, Mr. Carl Cadera, came to St. Charles and was one of the first graduates in 1989. He was a project manager with Blue Star Construction for 10 years. He was a skilled tradesman in construction and was often the one they gave the most difficult jobs to. When he passed away, everyone said the same thing. They wouldn't be where they were if it wasn't for Joe. His family, along with his colleagues at Blue Star Construction, created this award so Joe would still be a part of someone's story and his legacy would continue. I'd like to call upon Joe's wife, Minot, also a graduate of Holy Trinity, to present this award to Antonio Mora. Brian Collier was a former student who served in Afghanistan and was killed in the line of duty. The Heart of a Hero Award honors his memory and is awarded to a student who demonstrates compassion, commitment, and perseverance. This student is a good person overall. I'd like to call upon Mrs. Tanya Da Silva to present this award on behalf of the Collier family and the staff of Holy Trinity to a most deserving graduate, Frank Anthony Cayetta. The Lieutenant Governor General's Award is awarded to this graduating student showing exemplary involvement in the community. This award pays tribute to one student who goes above and beyond the required 40 hours of community involvement and demonstrates outstanding achievement through volunteer activity. This year's recipient is Alexandra Rye. I'd like to call upon Mr. Bebier to present this award. The Governor General's Academic Medal and Award is one of the most prestigious awards that a student in a Canadian educational institution can receive. A bronze medal is awarded to the student who achieves the highest average upon graduation from a secondary school. On behalf of the Governor General of Canada, I am pleased to present the Academic Medal to Michael Zalesnak.
Hello, hello. Okay, wonderful, everyone. Thank you for holding your applause to the end. I feel like I'm talking to my class. Well, we have one more speech, and that goes to the valedictorian of this year. Now, I asked our valedictorian why he wanted to work at KFC after graduation, and he said, "It's on my bucket list." So, please, I'd like to welcome up Raif Bakhtor.
Raif, and Dr. Bakhtor. Over the last 4 years, I've heard every pronunciation of my name, except the right one. So, good afternoon, everyone. My name is Raif Bakhtor. And before I even start, I want everyone to give a round of applause to the amazing graduates of the class of 2023. And before I begin as well, I would like to thank all the dignitaries, all the parents, teachers, and families for being here on one of the most special days of our lives. See, although I did believe that we all would graduate, it is still insane for me to be standing here wearing this gown and this square cap on my head. See, I still remember Miss Reeser coming into my grade 8 class talking about whether we should take academic or applied classes. And now fast forward 4 years, and we went to a presentation on which university, college, or careers we should go into. In September of 2019, during our orientation, Mr. Bebier, our principal, talked about how these 4 years would go by in a blink of an eye. And now I'm standing here at June 2023, and I can tell you he was telling the truth. See, in grade 9, I remember telling my parents I loved high school. And it's not because I loved doing math or science, but because it was the unknown. Yeah, it caused me to be a little anxious, because I'm not gonna lie. I was that kid who ran around the halls looking for his classes. I was that kid who, no matter how hard I tried or focused, I could not open my locker. But there was also this new freedom that we had. The fact that we can leave the school alone for lunch was mind-blowing to me. In general, everything was new and it was a fresh start. Now, that was the first semester. Let me tell you about the second semester. It was a solid 2 months, and this topic called COVID kept popping up on my phone and slowly started to trend everywhere. I remember talking about it in religion class, and Mr. Hartfield said, "Oh, everything's fine. They're gonna get it solved in a few weeks." And then March break came, and the best news at that time hit. We were getting 2 extra weeks off. But that dream of 2 extra weeks quickly became a nightmare of 2 years. See, COVID was the real unknown. The word "if" was used constantly. If we are going back to school, if we are gonna have exams, if our marks were gonna get affected. The days became stale, and I found myself doing the same thing over and over again. I honestly felt bad for the teachers. See, the news amplified students' mental health, but did not talk about the teachers nearly enough. See, we will never be able, yeah. See, we will never be able to imagine how it felt to do your job at that time. One day we were in class, the next day we were back in lockdown joining a Zoom link. I cannot comprehend how stressful it was for the teachers, yet all of them kept showing up, keeping us positive, and helping us attain our personal goals. So can we give the loudest round of applause to all these fabulous teachers? And to go with that, we need to thank our principal, Mr. Bebier, our vice principal, Mr. DiFilippo, Mr. Morrison, Mr. Borgia, and Mrs. Scott. See, although many things have changed over the last 4 years, one thing hasn't. No matter what day of the week it is, you will always find Mr. Bebier standing at the back of the school with a bottle of hand sanitizer and a big smile on his face. So, on behalf of all the grade 12s, thank you so much on being a phenomenal principal. And to Ms. Gennaro, thank you so much for your calm and soothing announcements each morning. Our school would never be the same without you. In general, I want to thank you all for creating a fun, healthy learning environment, allowing us to grow, and allowing the semi-formals, the carnivals, and much, much more. Without all your efforts, most of us wouldn't be here right now, and our school probably wouldn't be up right now. See, although COVID took away grade 9 and 10, it allowed me to appreciate grade 11 and 12. These were the years where we started figuring ourselves out. I left in grade 9 and came back in grade 11, and some of my friends who were baby-faced grew full beards. And others went from 5'5" to blocking my view in the hallway. But also, in grade 11 and 12, there were a lot of dark nights and tears shed due to the very confusing physics and calculus classes that to this day I've never understood. But what can I say? After all that, is we've made it. Through the highest of highs and the lowest of lows over the last 4 years, they've still been the best years ever. Those years were also the quickest years I've experienced. All of a sudden, we found ourselves driving to school, deciding on what we wanted to do in the future. And prom, yes, prom, the event that seemed so far came and went just like this. Everyone looked fabulous. A lot of people were dancing until they had to kick us out. But overall, it was a great night, leaving us beautiful memories. You know what? Even if COVID took over for a bit, I'm proud to say, whether it's in a good or bad way, we are definitely going down as a historic class. I truly believe we are one of the strongest groups of graduates. We've been hit with all kinds of setbacks, and we've still made it. When I say this was a crazier ride than any roller coaster in Wonderland, I mean it. We've been through ups, downs, twists, and everything in between. Yet through all of that, we are standing right here as graduating men and women and as an excellent future generation. Not only are we strong, but we are definitely entertaining. We had water fights, a slip and slide outside, or almost, camping overnight at school. Maybe it was us breaking the washrooms and having concerts in there and then finding it on TikTok the next day. Sometimes you'd randomly walk in and find different animals, like ducks. Or one day, I was sitting in French class. There was a power outage. I walked outside, looked to my left, and there's just a lobster walking in the hallway. We pushed the patience of our teachers to the absolute limit every single day. See, even though some of the teachers may be happy we're leaving, you can't lie, you will definitely miss the entertainment we created. When I won this award, I was first of all happy and honored that I was voted by my peers, but then kind of stressed because I wanted to make a speech that represents us as a group. But I knew if I wanted to do that, I'd be standing here until the sun sets. This group of young adults are the most intelligent, talented, charismatic individuals I've ever met in my life. I want to personally say to each and every single one of you, thank you. I'm so proud that I've graduated with all of you. Canada better watch out, because this group coming out of Holy Trinity, oh, I'm confident we're going to change the world. I wish you could stand here and see what I'm seeing right now. I'm looking at the future of this country, and I can tell you, it is a bright future. Okay, I know I've been probably talking for a while now, and it's probably getting boring, but if you're gonna remember anything from this speech, please remember this. See, the criteria of this speech told me to inspire you guys for the next leg of your journey, but I must admit, it is hard to inspire a group that is overflowing with inspiration. So rather than calling this inspiration or advice, let's call it reminders. One, whenever you're ripping your hair out because you have an exam worth 60% the next morning, or if you have classes from 8 in the morning until 10 at night and you feel alone or isolated, remember there is one who's always watching over you, and that is God. If you ever think you can't do something, remember that you can do all things through Christ. Two, no matter what, keep going. It's just like when you see that first question on a test and realize you have no idea what to do, so you keep going. Life is gonna keep moving, and if we stop, we will be left behind in the dust. So if you mess up on exams, interviews, or you know what, even your dream opportunity, keep going and understand that there will be better opportunities in the future. Don't be afraid of failure, disappointment, or any hurdles in life. Attack them and keep going. And lastly, does everyone know the saying, be comfortable with the uncomfortable? I have to shout out a specific class because this class constantly put me out of my comfort zone, and that is the Schism course. See, whether it was doing doggy CPR or helping a mannequin give birth, that class had me stepping out of my comfort zone every day. Doing the things that make you uncomfortable allows you to grow as a student, an athlete, an employee, a boss, but more importantly, as a person. See, the longer I was in the uncomfortable, the more comfortable I became with it. Mr. De Oliveira would always say a harsh truth, and that is, we are all replaceable. make yourself irreplaceable. The second you rest or stay in your comfort zone is the second you stop growing and become like everyone else. Graduates, it's now your turn to do the thanking. So can I ask you all to stand up? Please give a loud round of applause to all our hardworking and amazing families. Okay, you guys can be seated now. As we ended the year, a lot of people talked to me about how excited they were that they were gonna leave home and live on their own. And I do understand the thrill, but to all the graduates, please appreciate your families for everything they've done for you over your whole life. See, your friends may change next year, your favorite teacher may change, but it's your parents that no matter how annoying we get, they will never leave us. And parents, today is your day to celebrate as well. Be proud of your child's accomplishments, because I'm sure it wasn't always easy to get us here. Next year, we will all be starting over again. Some of us are going to workplaces, apprenticeships, colleges, and universities. We will be back at the bottom of the food chain. We will face challenges and uncertainties, but reflect on the skills and foundation that you've built here at Bradford and Holy Trinity. Yes, we will all miss Mr. McGregor's dad joke of the day, or Mr. Bebier constantly taking pictures of us. I'm gonna miss bothering Mrs. Bat and Mrs. Nogallo about editing my horrendous essays. By the way, I'm sorry for that. We are all gonna miss walking into school and finding random animals in the hallway, the Friday karaoke's, the teacher versus student basketball games with amazing dance moves by Mrs. Cavaco and Mr. Fahir. We are all gonna miss the random things Mr. Streichartz would yell in the hall, or I'm gonna miss Miss Singh asking me to get into uniform every day. By the way, I'm sorry. And you know what? I wanna see if he was listening. So, Mr. Streichartz, yeah. Can you say my name? And I'm definitely gonna miss hearing all the mispronunciations on my name. But as you can tell, I'm gonna miss it all. And more than that, I'm gonna miss all of you guys. It's been a hell of a ride, but we've reached the finish line. Ladies and gentlemen, today is your day. Live your life to the fullest. You deserve every single second of this moment. So I'm gonna say it one more time for it to really sink in. Congratulations to the graduates of the class of 2023.
Thank you, Raw If. Well done, Raw If. And thank you, everybody. And we should maybe take a moment just to think about the one person who didn't get to graduate with us today, Rudolph the Red-Nosed Reindeer. He went down in history. Thank you, Mr. Streichartz. Graduates, are you ready? Are you ready? As we conclude this significant milestone in the lives of our graduates, I would like you to now join me in a raucous celebration. Everyone, the graduates of 2023. All right, wonderful. Thank you very much, everybody. Please go home. Oh, and have a safe drive, too.
Thank you.